We are in Puerto Plata in the northern coast of the Dominican Republic, and today we're going to give you a tourist guide of all the best things to do in the city.
We're starting out today at the Teleferico, which is a mountain cable car that they have here. So apparently the Teleferico goes over the Parque Nacional de Isabel Torres, and you can either drive it, hike it, or use the cable car. We're going to use the cable car, so we're paying $20 US.
It should be pretty packed because there are a lot of people that they squeeze inside, but still should be really good views from up there. I'm pretty excited. I'm not like a scared of heights person, but this definitely freaks me out a little bit.
Teleferico brought you to a park at the top of the mountain.
Yeah, and it's like right on the peak of the mountain. This thing brought us high up.
Yeah, amazing views. It's super cool.
Super cool. Let's go explore.
So we had no idea, but there is literally so much you can do once you get up to the park. For example, there's tunnels, caves, a Christ statue, restaurants, a bridge, and a lagoon.
La laguna, no?
Sí.
Yeah?
La laguna,
sí.
A la derecha.
We've made it. It's right over here. Okay, so now that we're here, I would say it's all right. It is man-made, and after seeing actual natural lagoons in Sorrento, I don't think it can compete, but the hike here was super cool, so.
It's a typical little house, casita típica. Apparently they would only use it to sleep, but the majority of living would be done outside the house. Super interesting. We're learning stuff here.
All right, now we're going to the caves. The lighting probably isn't gonna be the best, but we're gonna do our best to give you a good snapshot of what it looks like down there. It looks kind of scary. I think this is where it ends. Are we videotaping?
I think so.
Oh,
perfect.
Look at this. This is so cool. It's like a little path of vines. Now we're gonna go through the Tunnel de Cayena, which is the hibiscus tunnel.
This place is cool. I think it would be a perfect place to bring kids. If you're in Puerto Plata and you're like, what should we do? Especially something that's kids friendly, this place with the nice little caves and the lagoon, it's just a great place to explore, especially for children. So that's my recommendation. For adults, I mean, it's fun. The views are really cool. I think I'd give it like a 6 out of 10. I think my favorite part is the nature. So if you're in dire need for some nature, this is the spot to get it. There are trees everywhere. All right, we're about to go down. Look at this view. It's been completely shrouded in clouds.
Interesting ride for sure.
Oh, with the wind, I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
And we're about to go down. We are only two people, so we were able to kind of squeeze our way into the next round. So definitely recommend going in small groups, but you can come with big groups. Just be prepared to wait a little bit longer.
Okay, we're here. Always have to be careful with these thin streets. Okay, there's a gap. Let's go check out the downtown.
Now we are gonna explore downtown Puerto Plata, beginning with Parque Central Independencia, or Central Park of Independence.
You just gotta love the colors here. Every single building has like white trim and then a just really bright tropical color. It really makes for a warm and just like happy environment. It's also really clean here. There's a lot of children playing with pigeons. Definitely a great first stop in the downtown area. Whoa, check out the cruise ship. That thing's massive.
Yeah, it's actually the central port of Puerto Plata. So a lot of cruise ships come to this city from the ocean. And we finally made it to Umbrella Street. Look how cute it is. There's a bunch of rainbow umbrellas that are just lining the streets.
I love the umbrellas. They're so pretty. And they like tint everything in just all sorts of colors. Definitely, if you're coming to Puerto Plata, you have to stop by Umbrella Street. It's absolutely adorable. Walking around the downtown of Puerto Plata is an absolute treat. There's so many cool things to see, and they're only like a few blocks from each other, so definitely worthy a stop. Now we're actually gonna go down Pink Street. Whoa, this is cool. Pink Street.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It is super pretty. It's pink everywhere.
Hello?
I believe I can fly. All right, final thoughts as we leave downtown Puerto Plata.
It's such a great place to go on a day trip. The town is so cute. There's so many colors, vibrance, and things to do.
Yeah, there's ice cream shops everywhere. I think colors, that's a great word to put it on. Mm-hmm. And it's free.
All right, now down the malecon.
There's the ocean, baby. And the malecon.
If any of you are curious what a malecon is, it's basically the main street that lines the coast of a city.
Lot of waves, lot of cars, a lot of people just hanging out. It's a great atmosphere.
All right, let's go eat.
On the left of the malecon, you have massive houses. It's hard to get a picture because they're covered in like trees and stuff. But then on the right side near the beach, you actually have a bunch of restaurants and people hanging out. Definitely worth a stroll or a drive if you have a car just to come down and see what the malecon's all about. Hola. Gracias. Beachfront dinner, yes please.
Yay, I'm so excited. First we have drinks and I got a lemon mojito. Oh, so fresh, really good, recommend.
I got a Presidente Light, which is a Dominican beer. This is my first time trying it. Auténtico orgullo dominicano, authentic pride to be Dominican. That's pretty good beer. Wow. Very cold, very fresh after a long day of exploring. It feels nice to drink this. Hello. Thank you.
As I'm really like reflecting on our time here in the Dominican Republic, I feel like the Dominican people have been some of the nicest people out of any other country we've been to. Like I felt so comfortable around them. They've been so nice. They've like smiled at us. These are like the first like people that we've like encountered where they like smile at us on the street. It's so refreshing and it's so nice and it makes me feel more confident
just like being here and just like having fun.
Go the Dominican Republic. This place is awesome.
So we decided to eat at the Carihuela restaurant because it's right on the beach. It has great vibes and it even has a view of that island out there, which has a statue of Neptune on it. So it's just kind of like, it has everything. It's got Neptune, it's got the beach, it's got good vibes. What more do you need?
All right, we got our food. We were gonna get pumpkin cream, which is very common in the Dominican Republic, but they were out of it, so instead they gave us vegetable soup and caprese salad, basically. Really hot, but really good.
Oh, wow.
I forgot about that. Gracias.
Muchas gracias. And I'm gonna try two really popular foods here in the Dominican Republic. We have rollitos de berenjena, which are eggplant rolls, as well as fried plantains, which are just super popular here. Oh, big bite. Those are really good. I love the mozzarella sauce on top, mixed with the Parmesan cheese. Awesome. These are fried plantains. They're like just a thick potato chip that's fried and flat, French fry. It tastes like potato, but they're plantains. And also a little bit of banana.
All right, guys, this is where we're gonna end the video. Thanks for coming with us as we went through all the tourist sites of Puerto Plata. And if you're interested in following more of our journeys, make sure to subscribe and like this video if you enjoyed it. Bye, guys.